Alright, I'm just going to demonstrate how to bake some normal starting from a low poly mesh. A low poly mesh is going to be a simple rock that starts from a box. So I'm just going to create a simple box with the same dimensions. And I'll just center that. And now I'm going to unwrap it now to plan so we don't have to do it in the future when it's a bit more of a complex shape. So I'm just going to add an unwrap file. That. Now I'm going to select the polygon and select by element, select everything. I'm just going to come over here and click quick planar map just to like reset it. Now let's drag it off over here. And I'm going to enter edge selection mode. I'm just going to select where the seams will be. I'm just going to do this. So the box will be. So one seam will go around like this, I'll loop around like that. We can come over here and click break. That will break the island. Now we can select this, go quick pill, and we'll get this shape here. Now we can just scale it down, make it fit inside for now. That's good enough. Alright, so that's that. So now we can just collapse that down. Compare that to an normal poly. Okay, now we can add more topology to this by just adding a turbo smooth. So I'm gonna add a turbo smooth and give it 3 iterations. I'm gonna add an editable poly on top. And now we can go into polygon mode. And up here under freeform, we can use the shift tool and we can start shifting this out into a random rock shape. So just give it some variation somewhat. If you come and get really stretched topology like this, you can come and use the relax tool and just fix it up with it. Go to the shift tool. Random shape going. It's a bit of a problem here. Just clean it up a bit. Also, just do that. Alright, so once we've done that, we can exit out of polygon mode. And now we can unwrap it again. So now add another unwrap modifier, open UV editor, and then we can see it's the same shape as how we unwrapped it before. Select the whole thing, come under tools, relax. I'm just gonna save before we relax. Change this relax by polygon angles, just start relax. And that should be enough. So now we can properly fill as much UV space as we can. And that should be good enough. And you can see how the seam is now the same as it was when it was a box. Alright, now we can export and get it ready for ZBrush and Collapse 2. We can now just reset the X form, Collapse 2. And now we can export this, export selected. Export to my folder. I want to export as an OBJ. Let's call it a low poly rock. Save. I'm going to select down here ZBrush. I'm going to untick these material because we don't need them. Just going to click export. That's done. Alright, now it's time to import it into ZBrush. We're just going to click import the low poly rock. Just draw it out in the scene. Go to edit mode, and now we can go under geometry, divide it a few times, gets rid of the low poly look. And now we can, to add a basic noise, I'm just gonna use a default noise template. in Noise Maker. So under Preview, Surface, you have Noise. Just click that and this should open. I'm just going to click OK. And you should see that there's just a random noise on the mesh. But I'm going to come up to Lightbox. Under Noise here, there's a bunch of noise presets that you can use. I'm going to use number 4. You get this look. I'm just gonna close Lightbox, come back to the surface in Edit, and I'm going to change the projection mode to UVs, so it uses UVs, and now we just bump down the scale. To get what we're after. You can also use this curve editor here to change some of the properties. I was gonna hit OK. And now this is what we have. Yeah, you can see the seams that are present. Now this is just a preview, so if you can see on the edges, it's not actually baked in. It's just like a normal map preview, kind of. So now we can come up to geometry. And we can convert BPR to geo, and that's just going to add enough density to support all the little details that we've added through Noisemaker. And now this is when you can manually touch up, add more details, clean up the seams, but I'm not gonna bother. All right, now we can export this. The way I always export meshes is under Z plugin, or Decimation Master. I just export all subtools, and I can just export this as high poly rock. It can sometimes take a while depending on how much topology your mesh has. Alright, so once that's done exporting, you can see that the high poly rock is 1.7 gig, that's very normal. Ranges from 1 to even up to like 6 gig. It takes ages to export. Now we can head back to max. And now to get more accurate bakes, we're going to create a cage. And we're going to create the cage. You always create the cages based off the low poly. So I'm just going to clone this, create a copy. I'm just going to call it box. No, I'm going to call it rock. Cage. And now with that selected, it should automatically be selected. We can just add a push modifier and we can just push that out. That should be plenty. So now the normal map will be baked based off the cage. So now picture that the high poly is between this cage and the low poly, and it's going to get like projected on all the little details. So now that's done, we can now export. We can actually collapse this down and then export this also as just rock cage. And export as an OBJ as well. Same story. And I'm also going to hide the cage. Going to also export the normal rock. So export selected, so export as an OBJ. We'll override that one. I'm going to include normals and smoothing groups this time because this is going to be a somewhat final mesh, and just export. Okay, now you can open up xNormal. You can just put this here. So under high definition meshes, we're going to put our high poly rock. Under low, we're going to put a low rock. And if we right click our low one, we can browse for external cage, so we can pick that cage file that we made. There we go. That gives you a warning that the polish has to be the exact same, which should it is, because we just copied it and just pushed it out, so it's, that should be fine. Under baking options, we want to just tick normal map. Default setting should be fine. Resolution 4K, I like rendering stuff at high resolution, even though if you plan to have stuff at a lower resolution later on, you can just resize it. It's better to work at a high resolution. And now we can change this target just to here. Let's go normal. Save. And now we can make sure the low poly is using a cage, external cage files here. And we can just generate map. Alright, so once the bake's done, we have our normal map here. I'm just going to load up Marmoset Toolbag so we can load up a quick preview. I'm just going to import the low poly. There's a low poly there, you can see the topology. I'm just going to create a new material. I'm going to import the normal map. And then we can just put the normal map in the rock. And there's our normal map on the rock. We can see how the lighting is getting affected by the normals. Alright, I hope that was helpful. This is one of my first tutorials, so it was kind of a bit sloppy, but yeah, take care.